Hey, this is Luke, and I'm here to show you how to use limit orders on Bogged. As you're about to find out, our limit orders are incredibly easy to use, and will help you get more out of your DeFi trading experience. I'll start off by explaining what limit orders are and how they work. If you're just here to find out how to use our limit orders, you can skip ahead using the timestamps in the description. What is a limit order? Limit orders come from the traditional asset markets, and are a way of giving traders more control over their entry and exit prices. Say, for example, you'd like to buy a stock when its price reaches a desirable entry point. Instead of waiting around for the price to fall to that value, you could just submit a limit buy with an exchange. The exchange will then buy the stock for you when your target price is reached. A limit sell works similarly, except it sells the asset at your requested exit price. Limit orders can be incredibly powerful for traders, as it allows them to effectively automate tedious aspects of trading. Many cryptocurrency traders are probably used to limit orders thanks to centralized exchanges like Binance, KuCoin, and Crypto.com. However, in DeFi trading, limit orders are a fairly new development. At Bogged, we created one of the first implementations of DeFi limit orders, and we've been improving ever since. To date, over 100,000 orders have been placed on our platform, and millions of dollars have been transacted through it safely. Our limit orders are known for their reliability. They'll fill for any token on our supported decentralized exchanges, and they're valid for up to a year after being set. Bogged DeFi limit orders are completely automatic. There's no need for you to keep your device switched on or run any software to use them. Right, so now that we know what limit orders are, let's find out how to set one on Bogged. On screen, I've got the Bogged limit order interface. Before I start setting my order, I want to make sure that I'm on the correct chain. For this trade, I'm going to be using the BNB Smart Chain. So I'll go ahead and select that in the drop-down menu. Remember, limit orders work the same regardless of the chain you're on. Now, I'm going to connect my DeFi wallet by clicking on the connect button on the top right. Bogged Finance supports many wallet apps, most of which support Wallet Connect, so we'll be using that option. If you're using a wallet that doesn't support Wallet Connect and need some help, then get in touch with one of our support team and they'll be able to guide you through using your specific wallet app. Anyway, I'm just going to open my MetaMask wallet on my phone and scan this QR code. Awesome, this means that I'm connected. Up here, we can choose between limit buy, limit sell, and stop loss. In this example, we'll be using a limit buy, but limit sells work exactly the same way. We'll have another tutorial covering stop loss orders as they work slightly differently. Now, for this example, I'm going to set my limit buy order for the Bogged token. I'll go ahead and click this button and there's a log bog from the list. If the token you want to trade isn't on the list, you can just paste its contract address in the box and it'll appear. I'm going to be buying Bogged with the BSD in my wallet, so I'll select that from the list. Now that the BUSD is selected, I can see how much I have in my wallet. I only want to spend $100 worth, so I'll enter 100 in the box here. The current price of Bogged is here, and I reckon I can get an entry a couple of pennies cheaper. Let's say this price. Here I can choose the unit of my target price. BUSD per BOG means a price of one BOG in BUSD, which is about 0.27 currently. We're going to leave it at BUSD per BOG. The third box should then auto-populate with the amount of BOG that I'm going to receive when the limit order fills. I'm almost ready to place my limit order now. There's just two small boxes I need to check out first. The token tax box is a box that I need to fill if the token I'm trading has a tax. I'd suggest finding that out from the project in question. Bogged has a 4% tax, so I'll enter that. Finally, I'll need to set the order expiry. This is the length of time the order is kept on Bogged systems until cancelled. You can set the expiry anytime you'd like, from a day to a year. Now it's time to set the order. There's two buttons, approve and place order. We'll need to approve the stablecoin before submitting the limit order, so we'll press that button. This only needs to be done once per token. It's to grant Bogged access to that token in your wallet. But don't worry, it'll only have access at the time the limit order fills, and no other time at all. You can always revoke the approval afterwards if you prefer. So let me just click on approve, and right away I get a pop-up in my wallet app asking if I'd like to approve Bogged Finance. This will cost a small amount of gas, as any wallet approvals are transactions of the blockchain which require a small fee. Now that the token is approved, I can place the order. Down here you can find a summary of the order containing the amount of BOG you'll receive, the target price is reached, the change in price required for your order to be executed, and the expiry date of your order. Placing the limit order requires $3 worth of native token on the chain you're on. Or, if you have some BOG in your wallet, you can pay with that and it'll only cost $2.50. Once the order is submitted to the blockchain, I can immediately check up on its status on this page. I can revisit it at any time in the future and cancel my order if I need to, before it fills. Otherwise, the order will fill it automatically up until its expiry. So how does this work when the target price is reached? Well, Bogged is now closely monitoring the price of my desired token several times per second. Once my target price is reached, Bogged will automatically purchase the token using the approvals that I granted earlier. So if this trade fails overnight, I'll wake up to find $100 worth of Bogged in my wallet. I need to make sure that I maintain the required amount of BUSD in my wallet, otherwise the order won't be filled. the BUSD isn't actually taken until the order fills, so I'm free to do whatever I like with that, but I need to make sure I have that token when the order fills. Alright, hopefully now you know your way around Bogged DeFi limit orders. Remember, Bogged has many other powerful DeFi trading tools such as stop losses. I'll be back again with some more videos covering those. If you're having trouble using our limit orders, then our support team would love to help you out. You can get in touch via Telegram group, or you can use our secure live chat feature in the Bogged app. Remember, if you use Telegram, our admins will never DM you first. If you want to keep up to date with Bogged, I've left some links to our Medium and Twitter below. Check those out if you'd like to learn more about the platform. We also have some educational content on Bogged Academy, so definitely check that out if you'd like to learn more about DeFi trading. If you like this video or found it helpful, then give us a like and subscribe. If you have any questions or comments about anything you've seen, let us know in the comments and we'll try to get to them. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.